and welcome to another edition of winemastery.co.uk. We're here to tell you about wine and try and help you to get to the wine that you really like as quickly as possible, the shortest possible route to the wine that you will enjoy. I'm John Lightford and this is
John Murphy,
and we're here on episode number 4. Today we're going to talk about red wines, but unlike episode 3, which was actually about 30 minutes long, which may be a little bit long for some people to digest when they're sitting in front of the computer, etc., we thought we'd split this one up into 3 sections. You can obviously just watch one after the other, so you can get the full episode in one go if you want, but it does enable you to digest it in smaller chunks, and we hope that suits you. Okay, so over to you, John. What are we going to test and try today?
Okay, well, as I said before, we always start off with the kind of more fashionable or popular grapes. What are the grapes which everybody will know? So this evening we've selected for you, we've gone for a Shiraz, a Cabernet Sauvignon and a Merlot, which are 3 kind of fairly basic grapes, as I said, more popular ones, and 3 grapes that you could pick up nearly anywhere. So we're going to start today, I think, we're going to start with the lighter, getting up to the heavier ones. And this evening we're actually going to start on the odd one. We're actually going for the Shiraz, which in general does tend to be a fairly heavy grape. But this in particular one we've chosen this evening is on the lighter style. So,
you said odd one, why is it odd?
Well, generally a Shiraz does tend to be the big, spicy, powerful grape with plenty of tannins in. I'll talk you through tannins later as well. But on trying this one, I actually found it's quite a lighter style of a Shiraz. But again, we're going to cover that as we get further on through the series. We'll cover the different styles of each grape from each country. So yeah, typically a Shiraz should be a massive, big, powerful beast of a grape. But this one is actually quite a light and easy one. So,
and in case you haven't caught the earlier videos, you've made a suggestion if someone wants to try to taste wine that perhaps before they just have some bread or something like that.
Just to clean the palate, crackers or so, just something like that, just kind of takes any flavours away that might kind of mask the flavour. Just makes it easier to pull more flavours from the wine, really.
Okay.
There you go, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's red. I've noticed that.
It is definitely red. Yes, yes. Now,
oh, I meant to bring my piece of white paper because you said you should have a piece of white paper to.
Yeah, generally, and it is obviously much more effective on your. Well, you could do it via the shirt. Yes. I mean, you can see from that one is quite a light purpley colour. I'd describe that one as. Oh. So you're looking at the edge of the wine there. You can pick more of the colour out.
Yeah.
And again, if we do the kind of the typical tasting, which obviously there was the appearance first,
yeah,
and then on the nose.
Yeah, that smells warm.
Yes. It
would.
Well, I've kept this up the stairs warming slightly because obviously the red wine should be served at a slightly more room temperature, definitely because you pull much more flavour out of it, out of the wines there, and it just kind of takes the edge off. Another tip, we'll give you a few tips on wine drinking as well as we go along, but definitely for red wines is bringing it up to room temperature and letting the wine breathe, because that kind of tones the tannins down in there. Now red wine, basically the tannins, which I'll talk about quite frequently. Tannins are basically that kind of dry edge that you kind of feel on your teeth and on around your gums, yeah, kind of thing. And then all that comes from really is the grape skin. Now, if you were to squeeze a white grape and a red grape, it's still the same colour juice that comes out. So to make a red wine, all they do is they leave the skin and the juice together. And obviously the skin imparts the flavour in there. Same as like when they're making a rosé, they'll leave the skin in there just for a shorter amount of time. So it just gets that pink hue, then they take the juice off. As such, so obviously the darker in colour the wine is, the kind of more apparent the tannins will be in there, and the tannins can be. Some people really like the tannins. For me personally, they're not my favourite as such. But also having a red wine with food kind of cancels those tannins out as such, so you can pull more from your food. I mean, they always say red wine and red meat, and it has been proven like the proteins in the red meat actually break down the tannins in the wine, hence why you can pull more from the wine. So let's have a go.
Okay.
See, with this one, as I was saying earlier, a Shiraz in style should be quite big and heavy.
Uh-huh.
That is actually quite light,
yeah,
and easy. I mean, all I'm going to get from that's more, it's raspberry. It's got the raspberry flavour in there, which again, isn't really what you would typically expect from a Shiraz. However, it's not unpleasant at all, and it's very nice.
So if somebody wasn't able to get this precise Shiraz, what would normally you be expecting for them to taste in perhaps a heavier Shiraz?
More kind of blackcurrant and pepperiness as well. I know, again, without getting a bit technical or something, you can smell and taste white pepper in there. Excuse me, now there's a hint of the smell there, but there's nothing in the flavour for me there. And the tannins are there. There is a bit of dryness there, which comes through not quite as strong as I would expect from a Shiraz. However,
the second time in, it certainly is. Yeah.
The second taste, always you get more from that, definitely, because it should give your mouth and your taste buds chance to take it all in. Mm. But yeah, that was just one tip on your wine drinking. Another one is, as well as warming the wine, we also like to air, get the air in there as well. Now, what a lot of people will do is, they'll open the bottle and leave it to air like that. But the problem being with that is, you're only opening that much surface area that the top of your bottle is. So what I always recommend is, if you wanted to warm up your bottle, just. Opening up to the air, obviously it's only that amount. So what I always recommend is taking a glass out of the bottle as well, then leaving it, because obviously you're opening up much more surface area there.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, back in the, there was a trick as well, back in the day, do you remember when you went into restaurants, you'd often find them passing a bottle of red wine from carafe to carafe, and that was just to basically get the air in there. You all right now?
You're all right now, thank you.
And that just, it really does soften up the wine. If the tannins are too much in there, if it's a bit too keen, I would describe it. Yep. That often helps. It can make a fairly ordinary wine taste pretty good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. And whereabouts is this wine from?
This is Australian. We've gone southern Australia for this one. And as I said, I expected this to be bigger, but that's part of the enjoyment of wine as well, because they're all very different. So typically, your Shiraz would be much bigger on this one, and it wouldn't be particularly one that I would say start on if you're just getting into wine drinking. I mean, it could be something that you really like, but I'd say start off a little bit lighter, which we will be doing in part two.
Excellent. Okay, well, that's for this one. Before we just cut off, I might as well deal with a couple of videos. That's what I covered. About a couple of emails that we've had in. One was from KTL in Bradford. And she asked the question that she knows she loves Chateau Neuf de Pape, but she can't afford it. Mm. What's a good substitute?
Yeah, Chateau Neuf has gone up, and to be fair, to get a decent Chateau Neuf, you do have to pay a fair amount of money for it, but it is a delicious wine. But if you're looking at something at a similar level, I would recommend a good Californian Cabernet Sauvignon. You're looking to match the kind of power there which the Chateau Neuf does offer. And I say, one of the heavier, bigger Cabernet Sauvignons from California, which you can pick up around about 10 to 15 pounds ish quite easily. But what I would always recommend again is going to your independent retailer.
Okay, fine, super. Okay, well, Kate, hope you found that advice. You saw one other email we had was somebody actually wanted to try the wines that we were actually drinking in the last episode. Where could they get hold of those?
Well, obviously, you can get them from ourselves. You could go via a link to our website, the Chervik website, or you could go straight to the website, which is chervik.co.uk. Every product will be available on there. You could just go to, again, most independent retailers should carry very similar stock to what I have, or if you go in and explain that it was a Chardonnay from what I've told you on there, they should be able to sort you out, no problem. You'll be able to pick up a few of ours or similar wines from the supermarket, but I think it's quite difficult to kind of select it. But if you get into your independent retailer and they'll sort you out, no problem whatsoever.
Well, we'll do on the website is I'll put the photographs actually of the labels, so you could print that off or take the details from those and take them. Or email us, and obviously John will get back to you with how we can get those to you if you like them. So, okay, well, for part one, on to part two.
Chin chin.
Chin chin.
You got excited there!